Hi, this is Tim, and welcome to the Math League YouTube channel. Today we have a problem from test number 12123. That's an elementary school test, and it is sprint problem number 24. Remember, sprint problems are usually multiple choice. I've left off the multiple choice options here, but of course, if you get the answer, you'll just pick from among the multiple choices. So here we have a regular octagon A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, which we have in the diagram here, wonderful, has a side length of 4. Now, one of the things that I often recommend in geometry problems is as soon as you acquire information, put it in the diagram, put everything you have in the diagram. So side length of 4, I'm just gonna put 4s all the way around this thing so that we have a record of that. All right, sometimes you can get away with not doing that if you know immediately what you're supposed to do, you can cut to the chase, but if you're not sure what to do, just throw everything you can at the problem, see what happens, right? What is the area of triangle GAD? Now, because they're asking for triangle GAD, I'm gonna go ahead and draw that triangle in the diagram. So I connect up G and A and D, and then I complete the triangle by connecting G over to D. Let's take a look at what we have. We have an octagon. Do you know any formulas for octagons? Probably not, and it doesn't matter. What's important is to realize that if you have a complicated geometric diagram, such as an octagon, sometimes you can make it simpler by turning it into smaller figures that you do know what to deal with. A lot of times turning things into rectangles and triangles really helps. That's gonna be our approach here. Right, so ultimately, we're going to need to find the area of triangle GAD. In order to do that, of course, we're going to need to compute the area as 1/2 of the base times the height. If we can figure out the length of the base and the length of the height, then we just plug those in and we have our area. Okay, so how are we going to do that? Well, again, if you don't already have a plan, sometimes splitting a more complicated figure into simpler figures will help, right? So I'm going to go ahead, I've already connected G over to D. I'm going to go ahead and draw some an additional horizontal line and a couple of vertical lines here. And notice what I've done with my two horizontal lines and my two vertical lines is I've split this octagon into 9 pieces, right? There's a square right in the middle. And then there are rectangles on each of the 4 sides of the square. And then there are right triangles in each of the 4 corners. Okay, let's talk about the sides of the square. First off, we know the sides of the square are going to be 4 also, because if this is 4, then this is also 4. And we can do that all the way around. Pretty much the only other piece that we need at this point is to figure out the distance from G over to this right angle. I'm going to call this point P so that we have something to refer to it as. So what I want is the distance from G to P. Well, notice that GPF is an isosceles right triangle, right? So the GP and PF are going to be the same length because of the symmetry of the octagon. Because of that, we know that this is a 45-45-90 degree right triangle. And if you know your results from 45-45-90 triangles, you know that if you have the hypotenuse, which in this case is GF, you just have to divide by the square root of 2 to get the length of each leg, GP or PF. Let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to take my 4 and divide it by the square root of 2. Now, the best way to do this is actually to get rid of having a root in the denominator. So I'm going to multiply the top and the bottom by root 2. All right? Multiplying the top and bottom of a fraction by the same thing leaves it the same number, but makes it look a little bit different. What I have now is 4 root 2 on the bottom, square root of 2 times the square root of 2 is just a 2. And then this, the 4 and the 2 are going to cancel out, giving me a 2 on top. And so I have a 2 root 2 here. So let me go ahead and draw that in where I need it. I could write the 2 root 2 in for every single one of these short legs, but I don't need to do that because at this point, I can kind of see where I'm going, right? I know that I'm going to need a length for GD, so I fill in the missing pieces there. I know I'm going to need a height from A down to P, so I filled in the one missing piece here. And at this point, we're ready. We have the base, we have the height. So the base, if you look over here, the base, I have a 4 here, so let me write in the 4. And then I have 2 root 2 and another 2 root 2. How many root 2s do I have? I have 4 root 2s in addition to the 4 on the base. Now for the height, I have a 4 and I also have a 2 root 2. So let me write those in. 4 plus 2 root 2. All right, this is my base. This is my height. And there's my answer, except I need to simplify it, right? It is going to be a lot simpler once we do all the calculations here. But at this point, we're done with the geometry. It's just a matter of, hey, I've got this number. I just need to make it look simpler, okay? So let's multiply this out. 4 times 4 is 16. 4 times 2 root 2 is 8 root 2. 4 root 2 times 4 is 16 root 2. And 4 root 2 times 2 root 2, well, the 4 times 2 gives me an 8. The root 2 times the root 2 gives me a 2, so I've got 8 times 2. Now remember, that's all being multiplied by a half. And let's go ahead and consolidate what's in the parentheses. I have 16, and I have an 8 times 2, which is another 16. 16 and 16 gives me 32. I have an 8 root 2 and I have a 16 root 2. How many root 2s do I have? That's 24 root 2s. And then, of course, I just have to multiply that 1/2 to each of the pieces in the parentheses. Half of 32 is 16 and half of 24 is 12. So 24 root 2 cut in half is 12 root 2. 16 plus 12 root 2 is our answer. And that's how it's done. Hi, everybody. This is Tim. Hope you're enjoying our videos. If so, you know what to do. Like, subscribe, turn on notifications, all that sort of thing. But what I'd really want to invite you to do is to send us an email at media@mathleague.org. Tell us which problems you'd like to see us cover next in our video series. Take care and see you in the next video.